never identified as a high outlier from the National Surgical Quality Improvement Project, also known as NISQIP, for surgical site infections. Our surgical site infection rate was above 20% for several years. We developed an enhanced recovery after surgery program at our hospital in order to address these issues. ERS encompasses the entire perioperative time frame, from preoperative, intraoperative, and postoperative.
All of the ERS protocols, everything we're doing with the new plan of care, is in an effort to decrease surgical site infection and speed up the recovery process so the patients can get home sooner.
Preoperatively, one of our most important components is that all of our patients meet one-on-one with our nurse practitioner in order to receive appropriate education.
It started off with my first visit with Dr. Much, who completely mapped everything out, answered questions, and that continued later on, both from him and his nurse practitioner, who is an ostomy specialist. And there was any time I needed to know anything, either one of them was a phone call away. It was great.
All of our patients receive oral antibiotics as part of their bowel prep, which has been shown to specifically reduce surgical site infections.
With the new protocol we have, it's standardized to where the antibiotics are administered at a more appropriate time and allowed to be completely infused by the time that the surgeon makes incision.
Intraoperatively, we irrigate the wound with an antibiotic solution in order to decrease surgical site infection.
So we went about establishing the best practices for the medications, mainly by digging into the primary literature. We referenced guidelines. We even reached out to experts within our own clinical institution and just sought their expertise.
Postoperatively, we encourage our patients to ambulate early.
So I was in for two surgeries, both the resection and then the reversal surgery. In both cases, I was up and walking the day after the surgery. And they stress that you know, you've got to get up and moving, and it only helps in recovery, and so I was quite willing to do that.
Walking in the hallway, not just walking in the room. We also like to record the amount of feet that the patient walks, because they need to have a significant distance to make an impact on their bowel function.
Additionally, we allow our patients to have regular food the day after surgery.
We've also changed the amount of IV fluids that the patient's going to be receiving after surgery, because if they have too many IV fluids, then it could cause the bowels to slow down.
So pain management and opioid prescribing is of great importance to the patient's surgical experience. So with that in mind, we wanted to address pain management by creating a multimodal analgesic regimen that relied less on opioids and more on foundational agents that are non-opioid based.
Our ERS protocol has been a success. We've noticed a drastic reduction in our surgical site infection rate. Where our rate was initially greater than 20%, it's now consistently less than 10%. Our length of stay has also decreased.
The ERS protocol is definitely the culture of the floor. We're to the point where we don't need to look at the orders, because we know exactly what every patient should have.
We are constantly analyzing patient outcomes in order to continually tailor the protocol.